outside.
We're losing power in the containment chamber.
You hear that? Something's close.
See, this is what I'm talking about. My heart is pounding. Get down, get down.
A Cubone?
We're not catching you a Pokemon, are we?
What?
Tell me you didn't plan this, Jack.
I'm sorry.
Jack, tell me you didn't plan this.
Are you serious? How dare you? Okay, of course not. Come on. Okay, maybe. There was a full moon last night, and my mom heard it crying its eyes out. Okay, she thought I was having a nightmare, so she brought me a glass of warm milk.
Dude, I thought you wanted to, you know, hang out and relive the good old days, like when we were kids.
I do. But just look at it. That is the perfect Pokemon for you.
Jack, I'm not looking for a Pokemon. I've told you this.
I've thought long and hard about this, okay? Water type is not right for you. Neither is fire type. But Cubone is...
lonely.
Exactly.
Okay, thank you, Jack. Thank you for that. Are there any other emotional truth bombs you want to drop on me?
Maybe later. But right now, the truth is in my hands.
Just give me the ball.
Yes. Yes. Okay, remember, catching a Pokemon is not about skill. So you can do this.
Good pep talk.
Okay, it has to choose you too, so make it want to be your partner. Yeah.
Hey, Cubone. What's up, buddy? You know, not everyone can pull off wearing the skull of their dead relative, but, you know, you sure can. Okay, he didn't like that. He did not like that. Jack.
Throw it.
Throw the ball.
Like a man.
I did it! Still got it. The light's not green. It still hasn't turned green yet, Jack. That's bad, right?
Run!
It didn't turn us right!
Run!
It didn't turn us right, Jack!
I can see that!
I'm not his choice!
That was one angry Cubone. He reminded me a lot of my mom. So, I don't know if this is gonna sound corny or whatever.
Just say it, Jack. I'm too tired to be angry.
I'm worried about you.
This again.
Hey, listen, everyone we know has left town, and now I'm leaving too.
Yeah, but that's okay. You gotta do what's best for you with the time that you got. That's what I'm doing. You know, I'm crushing it at work. Gonna get a promotion real soon.
What's the promotion for an insurance appraiser? Senior insurance appraiser?
No, actually, that's two steps up above where I'm at.
You're gonna make
right
me
now.
Throw up. That's not a real thing.
Oh, I finally have service. Wait, five voicemails? Why do I have five voicemails?
Maybe it's an insurance emergency. Who is it?
It's the Rhyme City Police Department. It was an accident.
Please don't. Actually, Matt, please do. Thank you. Thank you. You have a very generous tongue.
Does this lick of tongue belong to anyone?
Anybody? No?
Thank you for traveling with us. Please sit back and watch this short informational video welcoming you to Rhyme City.
Throughout history, Pokemon have been part of our world. Early humans used to catch them and train them to use their unique powers for the common good. This relationship evolved into what we now refer to as Pokemon battles. One man changed all of this. Howard Clifford, founder and chairman of Clifford Industries. Diagnosed with a rare degenerative disease, he resigned from his corporation and search the world for a cure.
And it turned out that the cure I was looking for was for me to evolve into a better version of myself. And I discovered how to do that through a partnership with Pokemon.
And he wanted to share that discovery with the world.
This is what inspired Howard Clifford to build Rhyme City, a place where humans and Pokemon can live side by side. Unlike other regions where Pokemon live in the wild, here, we live and work together. No battles, no trainers, no Pokeballs. A stronger, more harmonious world.
From all our citizens, welcome to Rhyme City.